Today, John Kettles and David Lindsay are testing an explosive that packs enough punch for the job.
This is P4. In offshore uses, it has various properties which we find useful. One of those is its high velocity of detonation, it's waterproof, and it's insensitive to impact. And it's very pliable, as you can see.
PE4, also known as C4, is made up of an explosive called cyclotrimethylene trinitramine, mixed with around 10% of plasticizer. Although it explodes about 5 miles a second, around 23 times the speed of sound, this lump of plastic explosive by itself isn't much use for cutting through steel.
Well, look at this. See what damage this is causing. Well, all right. Not much.
The 1.5-inch metal plate is hardly dented.
There's a slight indent in that.
By giving the charges shape, there's an amazing increase in the effectiveness of the explosive. The plastic explosive is packed into a steel liner with an inverted copper cone at one end. The whole device is fixed at a distance from the target in exact proportions to the geometry of cone and liner. It's now a ballistic device, focusing the energy of the blast in one direction. When triggered, the explosion inverts the copper cone, forming a molten jet traveling at 26,000 feet per second. With this relatively simple shaped charge, Kettles is attempting to blow a hole through a 1.5-inch steel plate.
Firing now!
The ground is scarred by the tremendous force of the explosion. The experiment is a success.
It's gone clean through, yeah?
Oh, there's a look at the hole depth, yeah.
Although
yeah,
the blast has been more powerful than necessary. Instead of just cutting through the steel plate, it's gone straight through it. That's and into the ground. A further 1.5 feet. That shows it could probably have driven a hole through at least 6 inches of steel.